Hi, this is Mark from Excel Off the Grid. If this is your first time here and you want to take your Excel skills to the next level, then start right now by subscribing and getting notifications so that you don't miss a single video. In this video, we'll be looking at combining rows into a single cell using Power Query. If you want to work through the examples with me, you can download the examples file and you'll find the link below in the descriptions box. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so here's our source data. We have a list of employees along with any equipment the company has allocated to them. We can see that Anna Watkins, for example, has a laptop, an access card, a phone and a home printer. Now the goal is to combine all of that equipment information for each employee into a list contained within a single cell. Before Power Query, we would need to use some complex formulas to achieve this end result. But with Power Query, it becomes a few simple transformations. With that, we're ready to load our data into Power Query. Select any cell within the table, then click Data from Table/Range. The Power Query window will open and show the data from the table. First, we will combine the equipment and the equipment attribute columns together into a single column. Then, after that, we'll flatten the rows so we have a single cell for each individual. So click on the headings for the equipment and the equipment attributes column, then click Transform and Merge Columns. This will open the Merge Columns dialog box, and in the Separator drop-down, we can see various options in there. However, we want to separate in our example by a colon and a space, which isn't in that list. So we'll click Custom, and then in the box below, we'll enter a colon followed by a space. We're going to give our new column the name of Equipment, and then click OK. So there's our first step. Our equipment has now been compressed together, so that the equipment and the equipment attribute is now in one column. Our next step involves using the Group By feature. For this, we want to click on the headings of the columns that we want to retain in the final output, but don't select the column that we want to perform the transformation on. So click First Name and Last Name columns, and then click Group By from the Transform ribbon. The Group By dialog box will open, and because we've selected multiple columns, the advanced option is already selected. You can see that we have our first name and last name columns already there, and if we needed to add more columns, we could click Add Grouping and add those. Let's give our column a new name of Equipment, and then click on the Operation drop-down. What we'll see is that this list contains a number of numerical aggregators. And because we're working with text rather than numbers, it means that in our scenario, all of these operators will create an error. That's fine, we're going to select Sum, knowing full well it will create an error. After we've been through these transformation steps, we're going to edit the M code so that the list.sum function that's automatically created is changed for a text.combine function, which does work on text strings. Finally, select the equipment column in the drop-down and then click OK. As you can see, our equipment column now contains errors, but we're now going to change the M code. Now, if the formula bar is visible, you don't need to do anything. However, if it's not, click View and then Formula Bar to make it visible. Now we can see our code. And we're going to delete the section that says list.sum and replace it with text.combine. Now, text.combine has a second argument, and that is the separator that is to be used. So we're going to put a comma, and then in double quotes, we're going to put a semicolon and a space. Click off that, and as you can see, those rows have now been combined into a single cell. That's it, our data is now ready, so we can push it back into Excel. So click Home, close and load 2, and we're going to load this into the worksheet. So we've got table selected, and then we're going to click existing worksheet, and we're going to put that into cell F1. Click OK to close the dialog box. Fantastic, there we have our end result loaded into Excel. And as you can see, each individual has their equipment listed next to them in a single cell. And all of this is because of the magic of Power Query. Right, that's it for me today. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. And I'll catch you next time.